Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll show you how I make mixed vegetable sabji. This vegetable I usually make it on days when I have some vegetarian guests coming over for lunch or dinner. This is quite a flavorful vegetable with vegetables like carrot, potato, cauliflower, peas, beans. You can add whichever vegetable you want. It looks quite exotic on the dining table. So let's get started. The list of ingredients are half a cup of coriander leaves, 3 green chillies, 1 inch piece ginger. You have to grind this to a paste with roasted coconut. This is 1 large onion finely chopped, 2 green chillies finely chopped, few curry leaves, and 1 small tomato. Then I have taken around half a cup of French beans, 2 small potatoes cubed, half a cup of carrot cubed, and French beans cut into 1 inch pieces. This is cauliflower around 1 cup cut into small florets. For masala I have taken, this is the Kashmiri chilli powder, this is the spicy red chilli powder, and my homemade Kolhapuri masala powder, turmeric, and this is asafoetida. Around half a cup of frozen peas. This is around 2 teaspoons of freshly grated coconut. I have roasted it to a golden brown color. Grind the coconut and the green masala to a nice fine paste. In a cooking pan, take around 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil. You can use ghee if you want, but I prefer cooking it in oil. To this, add around half a teaspoon of mustard seeds and half a teaspoon of cumin seeds. Once they start crackling, add in the onion, green chilies, and curry leaves. Fry till the onions are nice and soft. They need not brown, but they should be nice and soft. Once the onions are soft, add in the masalas and fry till the masalas are nicely fried and you get a good aroma. If you don't have the Kolhapuri masala, you can use any store-bought sabzi masala like the Everest or the MTR. Then add in the potatoes, carrot, and French beans. Give it a nice good mix. Add in a little salt at this point of time and cook till the potatoes and carrots are 70% done. I don't use any water for cooking this vegetable. It has to be steamed cooked in its own juices and the oil. Once the potato is 70% cooked, add the flour florets. Give a good mix. Be gentle, otherwise the cauliflower will break. Add in the frozen peas. If you are adding fresh peas, add it with the potatoes as it takes longer to cook. Give a good mix. Add in a little salt as per taste. And now cook till the potatoes and cauliflower is well cooked. Add in around half a teaspoon of chilli flakes and the chopped tomatoes. give a good mix, check for salt, and cook till the vegetables are done and the tomato is also cooked. See that you don't make the vegetables very mushy. Now add in the ground green masala and coconut paste. I haven't added any garlic to this dish. Give a good mix and let the vegetable cook for another 5 minutes, but see that the flame is on sim. Add in chopped coriander and cook for another 2 minutes. By now you can smell the flavor of the vegetables, the ground paste. This vegetable goes very well with rotis, parathas, naan, puri, or even with jeera rice. I usually serve it with parathas. I hope you like this recipe of mine. Do give it a try. I'm sure you will like it. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. Click the like button. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. Till we meet again, check out other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. See you soon next time with a new interesting recipe. Bye till then.